Smilesville. Welcome, Keeper. Before you lies a happy and carefree realm. The local champion, Lord Antonius, holds the first portal gem you require. Learn how to construct a dungeon and build up your forces so that you can crush Lord Antonius and wipe the smile from his face. Behold, your dungeon heart. Protect it well, for if it is destroyed, you will be banished forever from this land. Here walks the goodly Lord Antonius. 'Tis he who holds the precious portal gem, but only when you've mustered strength sufficient should you challenge him and claim your prize. Lair. Hatchery. First, there's money to be made. Click on the flashing seam of gold. Your imps will dig out the area you designate. Well done. And now your faithful servant imps will carry back your gold to Dungeon Heart. Once here, it can be spent. The golden scale atop the screen keeps track of your reserves. A start indeed, but more gold is required. 12,000 units should be mined. Red flowers float above your imps. These give measure to their health, their skill acquired, and reflect the simple thoughts within. Excellent work, Keeper. You are ready to recruit more creatures to your cause. See? A portal near your dungeon heart to where your imps must dig. They'll claim this portal to be yours. You'll see what beasts emerge. Your dungeon heart is full of gold. No more than 16,000 can it hold. Drop him, right-click anywhere on your land. Place of rest where creatures sleep to calm their tempers and restore their health. Behold your portal, the gate through which new creatures enter your domain, drawn forth to use the rooms which you provide. Your lair is built. Now right-click. Look well. A goblin has entered your domain. On his own, he is a cowardly beast, but in a horde becomes a useful fighting force. You must build a hatchery. Click here. Select the symbol of the chick, then click over empty tiles of land you've claimed to build the hatchery. The hatchery. A place where creatures feed on favored food. The eggs will hatch and chickens then emerge to satisfy their appetites. Good progress, Keeper. See? Your goblins are well rested in their lair and their bellies full with juicy chicken flesh. Now keep watch, for very soon more goblins will arrive, and then your numbers will be strong enough to challenge Lord Antonius. I sense a breach. The servants of Antonius have broken through your walls, and you can move your gaze to see them now by right-clicking on the flashing blade. But worry not this time, for it is only dwarves, who, feeble as they are, pose little threat against your goblins. The hapless enemy dwarfs are being crushed. Observe the white health flowers which appear above them. When they're near to death, you'll see that only one last petal shows. Goblin force is large enough to challenge Lord Antonius for his portal gem. Tunnel north and you will find your smug opponent skulking in his keep.
Away, Keeper! You shall not taint Smilesville with your evil ways!
He speaks, the feeble Lord Antonius. See how the petals of his white health flower are of a special shape. This marks him down as your prime target. Take him out. Bravo, Keeper. Lord Antonius is fallen. The portal gem lies aside his helpless form, in wait for Horny to collect it so it's yours. And comes he now. Ah, I see you have discovered a magical item. Devise new spells in the library. The training room lets creatures improve their combat skills. Keeper, you have successfully ended the life of Lord Antonius, and you have claimed your first portal gem as well. This is a most promising start. Sing song. A joyous land filled with light and music. Let us silence their wailing voices once and for all. This land is defended by Lord Darius, a far tougher opponent than Lord Antonius. Only by harnessing the forces of dark magic will you defeat him. Build a library to attract warlocks to your cause, and they will reveal to you the secrets of the arcane. The good Lord Darius presents himself against you now. He's more worthy as a foe. But use the runes you won from Smilesville to good employ, and you'll slay him dead just like Antonius. Library. Training room. First, build a lair, and then a hatchery, then claim the portal near your dungeon heart. Claimed a portal. A new species of creature has entered your dungeon. Your creatures require a place to rest. Build them a lair. Creatures will starve if you do not build them a hatchery. Training room is a place where fighting creatures hone their skills. A task well done, but training creatures will cost gold. More gold is needed. It's out there, ready to be mined. The basics of your dungeon are in place, but now expand it with a library. Design it square to maximize the space for scrolls, and let your imps make stronger walls to hold more shelves. now, a warlock has arrived to study spells within your library. His research will serve your magic well. Restrict him not, though, to his books, for when in battle he may prove formidable with fireballs. Every bookcase in your library will attract another warlock to your realm. Creatures make good progress. One improves his skill to level 2. A creature can train as high as level 4, but that's the limit. Further skill can only be attained out on the battlefield. Cannot afford to train creatures. Your imps have found some dwarves. These righteous little pests may stray onto your land, and if they do, destroy them, for that's what they deserve. The paltry dwarfs are now destroyed. Allow your creatures time to rest and eat. When ready, guide them north to find Lord Darius's keep. Spell has been researched. Mana is the currency of magic, and it's this you spend each time you cast a spell. Your mana level is shown in green atop the screen. Your land will gradually renew it as it's spent. Cast your new spell to create an imp. So open now the panel Spells and select the imp's head symbol, then cast it with a click on any land that's yours. A good cast, Keeper. You've made good use of your warlock's studious research. It is payday. Imps are creatures born of magic and cost mana to sustain. To improve their skills. To do this, drop a warlock in the training room. A left click on your creature picks it up. A right click on claimed land then lets it drop. Be wary though, don't drop them too near enemies, for the dropping stuns these beasts a time and makes them vulnerable to enemy attack. Searched. Your warlocks now have studied further, offering you another spell to cast, through which a thunderbolt is yours to hurl against such foolish enemies who dare invade your turf. Time has come for you to face Lord Darius. Tag the flashing tiles. Your imps will tunnel to his keep. Darius's walls are breached. Your forces now must kill his guards and stir Lord Darius himself to come defend his land. Darius has been roused. He enters through his hero's gate. Your forces now must kill him, and the portal gem of Sing Song will be yours.
Keeper, Dare not think that you will conquer me, you evil wretch. My dwarves and the power of good will drive you from this land. You seek to defile my realm with your foul sorcery. You will perish, Kiba.
Darius lies dying. Now comes Horny here to claim you the portal gem. Your progress is most pleasing. Treasury lets you hold more gold. Make traps and doors in the workshop. The sentry trap targets intruders with a powerful cannon. Use wooden doors to seal off rooms and corridors. Nunchaku. See, you blasted Lord Darius off the face of the realm. A most entertaining way to claim a portal gem. To hear their singing turn to screaming has been a tremendous joy to my ears. Shackle. This is a peaceful land, but a poor one, since its defender, Lord Avaricious, has frittered away his riches. If you can amass enough gold, he will surely be tempted into leaving his fortress and attacking you personally. Build a workshop, and fill your realm with fiendish traps and doors to protect your hard-won treasuries. Lure this fool to his doom, and claim his portal gem. Avaricious hides within his fortress proud. He's well defended, but gold's his weakness. To lure him from his stronghold, mine all the gold within his realm. Treasury. Workshop. Sentry trap. Wooden door. Recall, your dungeon heart will only hold a sum of 16,000 gold, so build a treasury for the excess to amass. You need a treasury to store gold. claim the portal. The swift, light Firefly is essential as an airborne scout. His eyes are yours to penetrate dark places and report. Your creatures require a place to rest. Build them a lair. Species of creature has entered your dungeon. A workshop should be built, so trolls will come and use it for their fabrication, benefiting you with traps and doors to help defend your underground creation. Attracted by the splendor of your workshop, his craftsman skills are set to serve you well, as one whose toil will make both traps and doors for you to use in your defense. 'Tis well built. Now, choose the hammer tab to see the workshop panel, then select the symbol for the sentry trap. Your creatures will starve if you do not build them a hatchery. To lure Lord Avaricious from his stronghold, mine all the gold within his realm. Build a bigger hatchery to keep your creatures well fed. torch flashes near your dungeon heart is a good place as any for a sentry trap. Now watch. Your trolls will fabricate the trap, then imps will take it to its designated place. To store gold. A sentry trap has been created in your workshop. Place well your wooden doors in narrow tunnels to slow down hostile enemies as they invade. These sentry traps will only fire if sufficient is your mana for their power. A new species of creature has entered your dungeon. Has been created in your workshop.
You thieving keeper! I will punish you for daring to despoil my land!
Click upon them. Lock trolls within your workshop, then watch them work without distraction. Although in time, they'll yearn for sleep and food.
Your destiny is to die by my sword.
Yeah!
this, my evil friend. Another portal gem is yours. Your wickedness inspires us all. Your sinful ways are glory to behold. Change. Corrupting the noble? Whatever will you think of next, Keeper? The sunlit kingdom of the heroes draws a little closer with each victory, and this was cleverly fought. Well done. Lord Avaricious lies broken before you with his gold in your coffers. Who says you can't buy happiness? Shady Grove. Your next adversary, Lord Ludwig, is currently patrolling his keep, considering himself and all of his subjects safe in this land. Known as a cowardly wretch, he has always relied on others to do his fighting for him. This is one battle he will not avoid. Ludwig knows your intentions, evil keeper. But mark, he cowers in his castle, locked away behind what he supposes is the safety of the drawbridge now destroyed by his own hand. From here, he has entrusted your destruction to his goodly warriors, whom he feels are more than equal to the task. For our part, we must know that they and he will perish, slain by forces under your command. Treasury to store gold.
Thank you.
dungeon keepers must retire to a lair of some description. Claimed a portal. A new species of creature has entered your dungeon. Thank you. species of creature has entered your dungeon. Observe the creature panel on your screen. Click on creature's numbers once or more to carry them, then drop them where you will, just as before. Observe also the symbols which lie beside. Use these to gauge your beast's activities, the number which now fight or work, and whether they remain good-humored. A wooden door has been created in your workshop. The guard room. Drop your creatures here to keep them lively and alert, thence ready for the fight. The flashing area which surrounds it marks the zone where any brush with trouble by your creatures will give cause for them to dash back and report, so reinforcements can be found. Make sure there's adequate provision for your minions' needs nearby, for though they are on guard, they still require their creature comforts, and it's wise to minimize the time they stray from duty. Possession spell. Cast on a given creature places you within its soul, your eyes behind its eyes, and makes its movement fully under your control. A wooden door has been created in your workshop. A new species of creature has entered your dungeon. You possess your creatures admirably. I see you're adept at this new skill. So, time to try another. Grouping. It enables you to band a number of your beasts together in a group. To do it, first possess a creature, then select the group key. Then look through the creature's eyes which you possess. And then, when you spy another, left-click upon the mouse. Behold, the Dark Elf. Her sniping skills as sharp as bolted arrows which she shoots. She serves you well in line behind your fighters and excels in duty as a guard. A wooden door has been created in your workshop. Thank you. door has been created in your workshop. Your create imp spell has been upgraded. You have discovered a magical item. Experience. A wooden door has been created in your workshop. A sentry trap has been created in your workshop. Payday. Your Thunderbolt spell has been upgraded. A sentry trap has been created in your workshop. A wooden door has been created in your workshop. Your possession spell has been upgraded. There is nothing left to research. Your dungeon has been breached. Claim the guard room. A wooden door has been created in your workshop. Yeah. Behold, Lord Ludwig's old decrepit servant Bob, who's left on guard alone. Disturb him and he'll call his comrades. It would be best if he stayed quiet. Possess a dark elf. Use her eyesight. Zoom your vision to the target. Once you have him, shoot and kill. Sure, that'll keep him quiet. Ah, I see you have discovered a magical item. Your creatures like your style. It is payday. creatures have been blessed with experience. Is too small. Stagnant water circles round Lord Ludwig's forts. Your imps will be unable to claim it on their own, so group your strongest forces in a band of one, and only then make bold attempts to reach the other side. As many creatures as it can. You have taken over an enemy portal. Rejoice! A second portal is now claimed. Prepare, as from it, 5 more creatures may be drawn forth to your dungeon. I see you have discovered a magical item. sentry trap has been created in your workshop. Sentry trap has been created in your workshop. Your treasury is too small. It is payday. Portals have attracted as many creatures as they can. Entered your dungeon. Oh, now it's wandered out again.
Thank you.
organize your security with the guard room. Stake your claim on new shores with a wooden bridge. Game Giant. Another land corrupted to your cause, and for once your minions are as pleased as you are. Lord Ludwig seems an old and overweight foe. At his peak, he would have been a far greater challenge. Still, you took a gamble and appropriated another portal gem. Well done, Keeper. Shadow. You face a strange quest this time, Keeper. You must not only conquer this land, you must also conquer fear. Lord Constantine has installed himself as master of all he surveys at Keep Fear, and protected himself with powerful traps. It is said that all who attempt to depose him turn back at their first attempt, their faces contorted with terror. Lord Constantine is a gutless knight who guards his gates with traps of fear. Your creatures may be loath to face them with their might. It's up to you to find an elegant solution to this puzzle, whereupon your thoughts may manufacture beasts so frightening themselves that fear's a paltry weapon to their sight. Guard room. Wooden bridge.